Hi and welcome back to this video. In this video, I want to do an overview of the Shopify dashboard. So I'll be doing all this in a single video, so the video might end up being longer than expected. So for the most important items, I'm going to do an explanation for them, but for other items which are not that important, I'm going to just leave them. So the first thing on the home, this is where you're going to find various links for quick items that you can do as soon as your store is set up. So you see, you can add a product, you can customize your theme, and you can add a domain. So you're going to see most of this throughout this course. And if you want to add a product immediately, you can just click on the button right there. And if you scroll down, you're going to see that right now your store is protected by a password. So if you want to disable that, you can click here to go and disable the password or to change the password. And you can also add payment providers and so much more. So just scroll down and see the options that you have. And about settings, so if you want to find out the settings or you want to change various settings for your store, down here we have this settings link. So if you go here, you're going to see all the options for your store, like payment, legal, pages, and so much more. And I'm going to click on this later on. And then orders. If you come to your orders, this is where you'll process your orders. You can view the history of your orders. Currently, this is a new store and I don't have any orders. You can also see any abandoned checkouts and you can see what you can do with them. If you want to retarget these people or you want to find out their details and just communicate with them, you can find abandoned checkouts here. And then under products, this is where you can add your products. You can track your inventory. So here under products, you can view all your products. You can add a product. This is where you'll be adding your products. And then you can do product transfers. You can track your inventory. You can create various collections for your product. Collections are just a grouping of products. Maybe you sell computer items. You can group them based on how those items can be categorized. So collections are just like categories. And then if you want to create gift cards, this is where you can create various gift cards for your customers and share them out. So once we have products, we're going to click on these different links and we're going to see more details about each and every one of these. So you can look at your customers' history, their customer details, all that can be found here under the customers link. And you can also track your analytics if you want to see how your shop is performing, you want to see the different products and reports, the sales, the visitors to your store, all that you can find under analytics. And then if you want to see the current status of your store, live view, if there are any live visits, you can track that. You can track that under live view. And then various marketing items. Let's click on this and see what we have here. So you can promote your products. You can sell the products and create various ads on Google, Facebook, Gmail, all that you can do here. So if you have accounts on these platforms for the different marketing options that you have here, you can create campaigns here. And then if you want to create discounts, you can create that here. You can create automatic discounts, or you can just create various discount codes that you can share with your customers and you'll find all the options here. And if you want to add any apps for your store, then you can find all the apps here. If you want to add any functionality to Shopify, you can come here under apps and just search for the apps that you want to use. So you can visit the Shopify app store and find the apps there and install them. And we're going to do all this at some point. So Obalo is a popular one. This is for dropshippers. You can add your products here and you can import products from AliExpress. If you want to do drop shipping, then you'll probably end up using Obalo. So these are some popular apps that you can try. And you can see that they've been used by lots of different people based on the reviews. Where is your online store? So if you come here under online store, this is where you will design your shop. This is where you'll change the theme. You can create pages, you can create blog posts. All that will be under your online store, and this is also where you can view your online store to see how it is right now. You see, once you click on online store, you'll get this option here just to view your store. So if you go there, you can see how your store is right now. And remember, the link for your store is what you chose when you are signing up. So you can see right now, it's just dummy content, but you can design it however you want. We're going to change the theme and we're going to add products, pages, and posts and so much more. So if you want to change the theme, you can just scroll down and you can see if you want more themes, then you can get free themes, or you can get to view the full catalog of the Shopify theme store. And if you want to get the paid ones, you can get them from here. You can also upload a theme. If you have themes that you bought from Theme Forest, or you bought them from anywhere else, or you made them yourself, you can upload them here. And if you want to change the code for your theme, you'll just click here for your current theme, and you can edit the code for your theme. But before you do that, always make sure you duplicate the theme, so that if you make any errors, you can always just go and reactivate the duplicated theme to overwrite the changes that you made that were erroneous. So in this case, if you want to change and edit the code, make sure you duplicate your theme first, and you can preview the theme and all these other items. If you want to customize the theme, that is, maybe change various items on the theme, like you want to add images, you want to add various locations on your theme, you'll just click here under customize, and you will be able to customize the theme in any way that you want. So that's it for themes. And you can also create blog posts, you can create pages. We're going to see all this. And you can also create navigations. Navigations, of course, are very important for user experience, to help people know where they can go next on your store. And if you want to add a domain name, you can just click here to add a domain name. So right now, this is a trial store for, this is a development store. And this is currently the link to my store. But if you want to add a domain, you can buy a new domain and add here. Or you can also change the primary domain. You can transfer a domain. You can connect existing domain. If you have an existing domain, maybe on GoDaddy, Namecheap, anywhere else, you can just connect the existing domain here. It's a very simple process, and we're going to see how you can do that. And you can change the preferences for your store. If you want to remove the password, you'll just come here under online store, preferences, and disable the password. Currently, the store is protected by a password. It's a new store. We haven't even added any content yet. And for the preferences, you can add this for SEO purposes. So if you want to add a title, you can do that here. You can add description for your homepage there. And if you want to add or connect your Google Analytics, you can do that here. You can also add your Pixel ID, your Facebook Pixel ID. You can add that there. And if you want to remove the password, you can enable it or disable it right there. If you want to change the password, you can do that there. So this is a password for the store right now. If anyone goes to visit your store, they're going to find a coming soon page, and there will be an option for them to visit the store using a password. So this is what that's all about. So let's see what's here under settings. So general settings about your store, you can change that there. If you want to add locations, maybe you do fulfill orders in different locations, you can add various locations here. And you can also change your account settings right there, billing information. You want to create gift cards there. You can change payment providers. You can also activate or deactivate payment providers there. And you want to change your checkout process. You can just see the settings that are there. You want to change your shipping. You want to create a shipping legal notices. You can do that there. Privacy policy and terms of service, you can find that there. There will be templates for you, and you can just click on the templates and edit them, and then you'll create pages based on those templates. If you want to upload files, you can do that here. If you want to change your sales channels, maybe you want to sell on your website, you can get the button for selling on your website here. You want to sell on Facebook, you can find the buttons there. The options are all under the sales channel. And then if you want to add your tax rules and the percentages, you can find the tax info here. Just add the tax information here for your site so that if people have to buy stuff and pay for VAT, then the options will be under here. So that's pretty much it for this video. And in this video, I've done a very brief overview of the Shopify dashboard. So if you're new to Shopify, then you can just click on these items just to see what options you have, and it will make it much easier for you to learn. So that's it for this video. I'll see you in the next video.